Do you like the feeling of power you have as a newspaper proprietor, of being able to sort of formulate policies for a large number of newspapers in every state of Australia?
Well, there's only one honest answer to that, of course, and that's yes.
From inheriting a single newspaper in Adelaide 71 years ago to growing a media empire that straddles the world.
And we can firmly announce the starting of a Fox News channel.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
You're seen as something of a threat by your fellow broadcasters here.
Well, yes, I suppose so. Or perhaps, you know, the barbarian at the gates.
A career plagued by scandal and controversy.
I'd like to say as well just how sorry I am to particularly the victims of illegal voicemail interceptions and to their families.
This is the most humble day of my life.
Disruptive, divisive, Murdoch shaped press and politics across three continents.
We all did too much cozying up to Rupert Murdoch. I think we'd agree.
Would Brexit have occurred without Murdoch's support? I very much doubt it. Trump would never have been president without the platform that Fox News created.
The Commander-in-Chief, the President of the United States, my friend Donald J. Trump.
And thank you to my very good friend, Rupert Murdoch. There's only one Rupert that we know.
The Fox News founder's latest blow.
A massive and coordinated effort to steal this election.
Chairman Rupert Murdoch acknowledged under oath that some Fox News hosts endorsed false claims.
The consequences of spreading lies. Fox News will pay more than $787 million to the Dominion voting machine company.
The media mogul now handing control of Fox and News Corp to his eldest son, Lachlan.
Our boss, Rupert Murdoch, is transitioning from chair of our parent company, Fox Corporation.
He's not going to go quietly. I mean, as he says in this message he sent to his staff, expect to see me in the office late on a Friday afternoon.
I guess some would say that I've been a disruptive influence at times, but I will take that as a compliment.
Well, Michael Wolff has written extensively on the Murdoch empire. He joins us now. Michael, how different is Rupert Murdoch the man to Rupert Murdoch the media mogul?
He's entirely different. He's the private man is runs from conflict, is incredibly inarticulate, is shy. Rupert is actually incredibly courtly, incredibly polite, incredibly mannerly, and is kind of conflict averse. Is not a man who you would think has been for 70 years fighting these great battles, winning and losing, but getting up again always and fighting once more.
So what do you think his legacy will be?
Well, I think that his legacy is a major one. He has held and commanded more influence and power for far longer than anyone else in the age we live in. He's transformed the media business. He's transformed politics. I don't think in a way you look at it and it's not like this is good or this is bad. This is just history. And that's Rupert Murdoch.
How do you think he feels about the link between Fox News and Trump's rise to power?
Yeah, there's no question. Donald Trump exists because of Fox News. It's an interesting thing to separate Fox News out from everything else that Murdoch has done, because and I think that in the end, Fox News will be the thing that he is probably most remembered for, but it is the thing that he has had the least to do with. He put up the money to start Fox News, but it was really developed and created and run for most of its history by someone else, a man by the name of Roger Ailes. Rupert, he's not a television programmer. He's not a television executive. He found himself, though, in that position when Roger Ailes was forced out of the company because of a long history of sexual abuse, and that was in 2017. And suddenly Rupert was the guy running the Fox network, and the Fox network very quickly became the Trump network. And I think that has kind of poisoned his life for the past number of years. And certainly during the past year, he has kind of stepped forward to say, you know, I'm not going to take it anymore, and I'm going to find another candidate to support who can defeat Donald Trump. Now, that has been entirely unsuccessful, and at the end of the day, it quite appears that that Donald Trump will be the Republican nominee again, and maybe the president again.
Michael, we really appreciate your time tonight.
Great, thanks. Bye-bye.
This is Real Life Secession. Now Lachlan is in the driver's seat, and he has come out on top.
Rupert Murdoch has crowned his eldest son, Lachlan, sole chair of News Corp and chief executive of Fox Corp.
This is really just Lachlan taking the mantle and saying, now it's time, it's his company only.
But successions rarely run smoothly. Rupert has six kids from his first three marriages. Only the eldest four get a vote in the family businesses, and they each have an equal say. So while Grace and Chloe will be looked after financially, Lachlan will need to keep Prudence, Elizabeth and James on side to keep his position.
After Murdoch's death, the other adult Murdoch children won't want to hold on to it simply for Lachlan to run. They'd rather unlock the value.
Firstborn Prudence has never been considered a viable successor, but her vote will count just the same. Elizabeth, always considered the rebel of the family, is publicly, politically to the left of Lachlan. And James, once the heir apparent himself, resigned over certain editorial content on Fox News. They'll have to form alliances if they disagree over the future of the global media empire, or if they agree over one critical choice, like Lachlan's future.
A lot of people are saying, you know, is he up to the job? Can he handle the power? Does he have the skills?
So, has Rupert given Lachlan a golden crown or a poisoned chalice?
Paddy Manning has a great name and is also the author of the Lachlan Murdoch biography, The Successor, and he's here to give us all the juicy goss. Paddy, thanks for joining us. So why is Rupert handing over the keys to the kingdom now of all times?
Well, if you think about it, Rupert Murdoch's had a crazy year. He had professionally and personally, he had a sort of on-again, off-again engagement. He's now apparently got a new love interest, but he's also had a wild ride at Fox and News Corporation, where, you know, this year we've seen them pay, the highest defamation payment ever, $787 million to a voting machine manufacturer over the big lie in the 2020 election. So I think that Rupert, at the age of 92, has kind of come to the view that after 70 years in the business, he deserves to retire.
He's made it pretty clear how he wants this succession plan to play out with Lachlan at the top. But there's a lot of speculation that upon Rupert Murdoch's death, Lachlan may be ousted by his siblings. Why would they want to get rid of their brother?
It's crystal ball gazing to try and anticipate what might happen. But one thing I was told when I was researching my biography of Lachlan was that the siblings were concerned about, in particular, Fox News's role undermining American democracy, and that they were determined to take back control of the Murdoch media businesses once Rupert passed. And so in that situation, you could imagine the three siblings ganging up to tell Lachlan to either bring that business to heel or even to roll him.
What do you think Lachlan would want his legacy to be?
Well, Lachlan is very different from Rupert. That's what I found writing the book about Lachlan. I think there's been an assumption that Rupert he's an inveterate kind of kingmaker, and he's been a powerful figure on the world stage now for decades. But Lachlan is not the same as his father, and he's not tried to be. Lachlan is a businessman first and foremost. He doesn't see himself as the all-powerful kind of editor-in-chief intervening in programming or, you know, decisions on editorial on a daily basis. That's not his gig. He wants to focus on the business. His focus is on the bottom line and on thinking about what should the company's strategy be to deal with, whether it's streaming or, you know, digitization in newspapers. And he's got actually some runs on the board in dealing with those issues. even if, you know, they've had a terrible year at Fox in particular with the with that Dominion settlement, and there's more you know, payouts likely to come.
Paddy, I've done a lot of research recently, and obviously Lachlan is all the chat today, but do you think Kendall was the man for the job, or equally that Shiv could have done it?
Well, I think a lot of people think Kendall is Lachlan, but actually Lachlan is Roman. And yeah, Kendall is your James figure.
Okay.
So Kendall is the one who quits on principle. And that is kind of what James has done by kind of declaring his criticisms of the Murdoch media's coverage on climate change, for example, or on the big lie President Trump put out in the 2020 election, and which led to the insurrection.
I see, Pat. I'll have to go back to my research.
That's like the biggest scoop we've had all night. Yeah, thank you very much, Patty. What a bombshell.
I think I'm a big fan of Sarah Snook, so I've got a plump for Shiv.
Thanks for your time, Patty. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
We've watched a lot of commentary around this today, and I have to say that Patty there comparing Lachlan to Roman, I was like, I get it. That makes so much sense.
Also, we should apologise. We should have warned you up front that you will see footage of topless Rupert Murdoch in that package. For anyone having dinner, I apologise.
Yes. I'm fascinated by this because I think people thought that Rupert Murdoch, a lot of people thought he was this overarching, you know, big, powerful, you know, some would say evil person, right? And with this change to Lachlan, will things change? Well, if what we're hearing is that he's a business-minded person, and we see the business model of Fox, of News Corp, is, you know, inflammatory rhetoric that will kind of engage people to be angry and furious and therefore be scared and buy things. I mean, that's not going to change at all. That's I don't think we're looking for a big change here.
But also interesting to think he's sitting back and watching that and being okay.
I mean, like, yeah, it's
money in my pocket. I don't care.
Yeah,
it's wild.
It's also interesting that you insisted on that topless footage, by the way.
Yeah. Well, that's the power I have watching this show. I want more 92-year-old topless photos.